Hi everybody and welcome to Papa Hiker's video series on how to use your tarp as a shelter. It has been years since I uploaded tarp technique video number one. Finally, it's time for video number two. Tarp technique number one was a video about guy lines, stakes and tie out points. Tarp technique number two is a video on how to use those methods to create the actual shape of the tarp. So how to make the actual pitches 3D in the space that you have. In this video, what are we trying to achieve? So what's the goal? How to tension the different areas of your tarp? And in what order do you pitch a tarp? And let's start with what is our goal? We are covering an area, a rectangular box, that is Papa Hiker shaped at minimum and is 40 centimeters, 1.5 feet high everywhere. Why? Because every part of your shelter that is lower than that may be functional. It's a good place to put stuff. It shelters you from diagonal rain and it covers you from the wind. But it's too low for you to lie under. And that extra room between you and the sides of your tarp is important. You want to pitch it so that when you lie down or when you sit up, you do not touch the sides, because a tarp is a single layer shelter. That means that condensation will form on the inside. And if you touch it in your sleep, you will get wet. We want a shelter that will pretty much keep its shape when the wind blows. So we wanted to divide the forces evenly over as many points as possible, so that your tie outs and your guy lines don't tear and your pole does not bend or break. Now, a stake that comes out of the ground, or a tie out that cams, those things are not bad at all. A torn corner, that is a problem. We want the tarp to shelter you from the wind from at least one direction. We want the tarp to be as quiet as possible when the wind blows, so that you get a good night of sleep. We want the rain or snow to run off of the tarp, away from you. So, no pooling on the roof. In any place on your tarp, a roof angle of 45 degrees is optimal. This is also the best angle for wind stability. We want to get in and out of the tarp easily. Whee! Long story short, we want strong, tight pitches that you can happily spend the night in. Now I want to show you how to tension the points of your tarp. And the lean-to is an easy pitch, and it's easy to visualize what can go wrong if you pitch this tarp. Now what I'm doing is I am tensioning these four edges of the tarp. And if I do that equally, the middle of the tarp will automatically be tensioned correctly. This is a pretty short side of the tarp. I don't need a lot of tension to tension it correctly. This is a longer side of the tarp. I need a bit more force to tension that correctly. So ideally, the angles here would go slightly shallower there, so that I have more tension here with the same amount of force as I have here. Now I'll show you what can go wrong. For example, if I have less tension here, and I try to correct that problem on this side, what happens is this. Oh, so this is starting to look all right. This is starting to look all right. Just that one a little bit. Great. Now, this may look like a well-tensioned tarp, but really it isn't. Now, as you can see, this is all wrong. From the angle of the lines, you can see that I am putting a lot of tension and force on this side of my tarp and far less on the long side of my tarp. That means that if the wind picks up, there's one place that it may tear, and that is at this corner or at this corner, while I still have not enough tension on the longer sides of my tarp. So this is why my message is very simple. Tension the sides of your tarp equally. Now, my shelter stands with the minimum amount of stakes and guidelines that you need to make the actual shape of the shelter. I'm going to put in lots more, but that's only there for reinforcements to make your shelter stronger, not to change the shape of your shelter. Now, for example, look at this tie out. Where am I going to stake it? Now you could think to yourself, that one goes to the left, that one goes to the right, so this one goes in the middle. But if I do that, I would be pulling this downward, which I don't want. This is my living space inside. So to only reinforce this shelter and not change the shape, I am following the line that goes to the peak of the shelter and continuing downward there, stake it out on that side. This will make your shelter stronger, but it will not change the shape of it. Look at the triangular door of this cave setup. Here is a triangle. This is the short side, that's the long side. We want the stake to tension both the sides, this one and that one, which is why we're not pointing it here, we're not pointing it there, but we're pointing it there. Now, if you corner it more towards here, there will be more pressure there. If you corner it more towards here, there will be more pressure there. So I have tried to make it equal. The shelter shapes are usually made of several triangles that link together to form your shelter. And you make it much easier for yourself if you start building one of the triangles that you know where it goes. And it's not depending on other triangles to get the shape. So in this case, I'm building somewhat of a tarp tent, and it has a big triangle in the back, and I can just build that triangle where I want it to go, and the rest of the shelter will follow that shape. And as you can see, I am not pulling this back edge very taut, and I have a very good reason for that too, because later on I will shape this shelter, a lifter point will come up, that part will move inward, and then a good shelter will result. So as you can see, if I had started making the back triangle first, everything else would have fallen into its place just perfectly by itself. But now I have to restake three times and maybe still end up with a bad shelter. End of story, make one triangle, make it right, do the rest. We'll be right back.
With the pyramid pitches, the approach is different because you have to lay out the floor plan first and then put in the pole to find the height. That's more complicated. You have to put those stakes in right straight away. Now there are pyramid pitches that have a fixed floor plan, like the low tetra. It can only go in one configuration, no variation possible. But this one is a little complicated, a little more complicated. This is the lengthwise pyramid. And if you put the side stakes too close together, these points will come up. That doesn't work. So in all cases, what you do is these tie outs, you place them halfway. So not at the extreme end, not at the extreme beginning, so that you have a little wiggle room later on. I find that I place these too far apart and I can't get the other ones tight. Simple solution. If you plan on using lifter points, you need to give your shelter some slack to accommodate for your lifter points, changing the shape of your shelter later on. This is a good example. This is the V-Fly. And as you can see, it looks very shitty here like this. This is because I have given it some slack and all that slack is now hanging down. What I'm gonna do is lift it with a lifter point and you will see that all that slack downwards will transform into slack upwards, which is a good thing because then I have a roomy shelter.
That's it for tarp technique number 2. Thanks a lot for watching and do subscribe, Papa Hiker.